Frank Zane was born June 28, 1942. He changed the stereotype of bodybuilding. No more big muscles and no brains. Frank received a Bachelor of Science degree in education from Wilkes University, Pennsylvania in 1964. He taught chemistry and mathematics while living in California and Florida. In 1967, he taught mathematics in New Jersey for 2 years. He then went on to teaching math at Mark Twain Junior High in Venice, California. He earned a Bachelor of Arts degree in psychology from Cal State in 1977. He didn't stop there. He went on and earned a master's degree in experimental psychology from Cal State in 1990. Frank Zane had an illustrious career. He won the most revered title in bodybuilding history 3 times. The Mr. Olympia, he won it in 1977, 1978, and 1979. He is one of very few that ever beat Arnold Schwarzenegger in a bodybuilding contest. Frank's reign turned bodybuilding upside down. He shifted from the huge muscular build to the Hercules Steve Reeves build. Good-looking aesthetics, Zane's physique was well-proportioned, and he had the second thinnest waist of all time. Only bodybuilding legend Sergio Oliva had the smallest. Frank's V-taper and shoulders and abdominals may be the best in history. He competed at 190 pounds. But to win the coveted Mr. Olympia titles, he listened to bodybuilding kingpin Joe Weider and went over the 200-pound mark, training with heavier weights. In 1980, Arnold Schwarzenegger wanted to promote his new movie Conan and decided to compete in the 1980 Mr. Olympia contest. Frank Zane placed third that year in Arnold's comeback victory. Frank didn't like that too much. Frank and many other bodybuilders boycotted the 1981 Mr. Olympia. Frank also beat Arnold Schwarzenegger in the 1968 Mr. Universe. Frank competed for 20 years, retiring after the 1983 Mr. Olympia. Frank Zane was inducted into the first annual Joe Weider Hall of Fame. He also received an Arnold Schwarzenegger Lifetime Achievement Award in 2003. Imagine that. Frank was nicknamed the Chemist due to his Bachelor of Science degree. He knew just how to peak in size on the exact day of competing, a skill that many others can't do. He married a beautiful woman named Christine, and they owned and operated Zane Haven in California. They had one-on-one sessions with clients. Today, the Zanes live in San Diego, California, and run his learning center called the Zane Experience. In 2005, Frank worked as a consulting producer in the movie See Arnold Run. Frank Zane was rumored to be chosen to play the movie Batman in 1989. He was the perfect choice in body. He had Bruce Wayne looks. He was a fitness model before there was fitness models. The ladies went wild when they saw Frank shirtless in expensive jeans, but the Hollywood elite chose the safer choice for the 1989 movie Batman. They didn't want an unknown actor, so they chose Michael Keaton and it added muscles to the Batman suit. Boy, did they make a mistake. Frank was a great speaker, and Batman used one-sentence lines like, "Alfred, please get me this," or "get me that." Arnold Schwarzenegger starred in the movie Conan, which did great in 1980, but his English wasn't even that good. Frank Zane taught English. Need I say more?
Folks, what you been waiting for? I've been talking about the 1981 Mr. Olympia scandal and how I had the inside scoop on who really won. Well, folks, part one, I'm going to show you in a couple seconds. And after you watch what you hear when Dan Padilla interviews Frank Zane. Wasn't planned, wasn't rehearsed. This just happened. Castellano, the Castellano Vaults. I got so much more. This is only the beginning. Watch and learn.
I just opened the Flex magazine this month, and with you as one of the top 20 most aesthetic physiques in the history of the sport.
Oh, well, thank you. You know, I just got that magazine. I haven't seen that yet, but always glad to make it into the print pages, you know, and keep the image out there. But you were one of the greatest physiques of all time. Most perfect structure ever, I think. And muscle insertions and everything, and I think you're really underappreciated. You should have won the Olympia in 1981. If I was the judge, I would have voted for you.
Well, forget about me. This is about you. You're one of the greatest bodybuilders in our history. Besides Arnold and some of these guys, you're one of the only guys people don't know. I know the history of the sport that defeated Arnold.
Yeah. Well, I wasn't in shape in 1968, and I was, and that made the difference. But I do have the distinction of being the leanest guy ever to win the Olympia, which by contrast, guys now are 100 pounds heavier than I was. Most I ever was to win, it was 190. And now Coleman's coming in at 290, 295.
Right. What do you think of the guys today compared to our time when we competed? Are you appreciating these new physiques? All our lives as kids, or as growing up in the sport, everybody wanted to be the biggest, strongest ever. Now
I think you do. I think you do when you're young. You want to get bigger. And I did too. But I realized that I couldn't get real big because I have a small bone structure. And I knew that if I was going to make it to the top, it had to be through detail and proportion. And muscle, you know, getting in hard shape and do presentation and posing. And so I appreciate the work they're going through, but I think they spend too much focus and energy on just getting big, period, and not developing quality, which takes time. Proportion and quality and the lines and the fine details take a lot of time, and they're not putting it, you know, they're around for a long time, but it's always trying to get bigger and bigger.
I myself, I feel the same way. You're communicating something that I try to tell all the kids of our area. I always try to promote education first, and then I'll help them with a little bit of training. Now, what do you think of the new diets today compared to our diets?
I was always interested in doing what worked, and that was basically eating a good amount of protein, restricting my carbohydrates, but not for extended periods of time, and keeping my fats relatively low to moderate. And I've always done that. It's always like a training diet for me. I just get a little bit more strict when I have to, you know, get into peak condition. But it always comes around to that, you know, the South Beach diet, the Atkins diet, they all have elements in common with what we did. But I think you got to, anybody who's looking for the magic diet to do it for them is just wasting their time. You got to find what works for you, and that's what we all did, and we knew what to do.
Definitely.
Folks, with all the stuff you saw on the internet, now we got three-time Mr. Olympia, Frank Zane, saying Dan Padilla, if he was judging the show, would have won the 1981 Mr. Olympia. He even boycotted it because he thought there were some strange things going on with the judging. But anyways, if that's not enough for you, don't think Castellano's going to stop here. I got plenty more. This is only the beginning. By the time you're done, you're going to know who the winner of the 1981 Mr. Olympia was. And folks, if I got to step on toes, I got to step on toes. But Castellano's going to tell the truth.